Hey you guys, welcome to my home. While I am doing quarantine, a lot of the things that I've been doing is video footage. Watching myself from before and kind of deciding what I've been doing wrong, how I've improved, how I can get better. And it is a really good way to just kind of like get better overall. And I thought while I'm doing this, why not just share it with you guys? So I'm gonna do this new segment called Shari Explains, where we are going to basically coach past Shari over video footage. And I'm excited to share it with you guys. So let's get into it. The first video that we're gonna look at today is gonna be shot put, just because I think it's one of my favorite events to practice because I've gotten so much better at it. And so yeah, let's pull up the video right now and just watch it. Okay, so that is me exactly, almost to the day, exactly 3 years ago. This is when I was actually training in Santa Barbara. And I want to back up. I actually started doing this step-step in Santa Barbara, California. I was taught by Ashton Eaton and Brian Tyson Eaton, who are amazing athletes. They came to train in Santa Barbara for just warm weather training. And while they were there, they were doing the step-step and I was doing the glide and just not doing very well. So I talked to them about why they decided to do the step-step and they were like, you really should try it. They taught me how, and then yeah, that's how I kind of got into the step-step. So the biggest points of why I do the step-step is because I am a left-footed jumper, but with the glide, you're kind of pushing off of your right foot. So with the step-step, your first step push-off is from your left foot if you are a right-handed jumper. And so for me, it was just kind of like a big advantage to be able to push off that left foot because it has a lot more power. And the other reason I really love the step-step is it's really gotten me to hit the correct position easier. And so I'm really able to use my hips into my throw. This was my first little bit of me trying the step-step. So I think it's important for us to keep that in mind as we go through this. And I can kind of show you what to do better. For me, if you're just looking at me, if you have any of these same issues, that's great. And if you feel like you need a comment down below and tell me what you really think that I was doing wrong that I didn't catch, you are more than welcome to. So we're gonna slow this down just a bit. From now, what I do is I start all the way tall. Do you see how when I'm starting down and I kind of bounce into it? I actually start tall and then drop into it because I let gravity give me a little bit more push. That's just something that I like to do now that has changed. So I'm getting a big push off of my left foot, which it actually kind of looks like I stepped off my left foot instead of really pushing off of it. You're getting into your throat. And if we look right here, before I even plant that second foot, I'm already shifting onto that other foot. So there's this big shift in my hips. Do you see how the shift is happening without me actually doing anything? So that there's no way that throw went very far at all. I'm getting almost no push off the ground for me to actually get a trajectory shot put going on. Let me actually show you. I'm going to get up and I'm just going to show you kind of exactly what I mean, what I'm doing versus what I should be doing. So we are getting this push off of this foot and I feel like I was mostly stepping off of it. It's really important that you get that big push off of it. And then when you're landing, it's also very important. I kind of was landing like this and then I was shifting my weight onto. So what you want to do is you want to get a big push and you want to be up on the ball of your foot, up on the ball of your foot so that you can turn your knee into the ground. Knee goes towards the other opposite ankle. So you come back, your knee goes toward the opposite ankle and then you come up on top of it. So you're getting a push off of this leg. This is a much more powerful motion than this is. This is not nearly as powerful as this. And if you can get this kind of trajectory, you will have much more luck than you will with this kind of trajectory. You really want to get the knee to the ankle so that your hips are absolutely into the throw, so that you can come up over it and get the full extension. So important to do that. I hope that example made sense. Now we can come back and I can show you exactly a little bit more detailed. So see, first you get the push. Do you see how my foot is still pointing back? I'm not really on the ball of my foot when I'm turning. I'm kind of just coming off of my right toe and not really getting any push. Now, if I were to stay on the balls of my feet and really dig, get that knee while my foot's still on the ground, get my knee to come down where my ankle is, I would still have the ball in my hand right now instead of releasing it. And I would get so much more push because I would still be on the shot for way longer. And the longer you can be on the shot and still be explosive, the further it's gonna go. And so I really hope this was helpful. I had a lot of fun. Hopefully I can do more of these because I actually really enjoy them. I'm doing it, and so I just figured that while I'm doing it for myself, I can help you guys out as well. Any requests for me? I would love for you to send me any videos from my past that you want me to do. That'd be awesome. So if you have any specific events that you want me to go over, feel free to let me know in the comments. And then, thank you guys so much, and I will see you next time.